The PlayStation 5 launch is being destroyed by scalpers. Sony is losing out of millions of dollars. But the question for you is, who is at fault? Is it the scalpers and their bots, or Sony for not being prepared? In case you aren't aware of the term scalping, it's when someone mass purchases a certain product, then waits until the supply is low for that product, and then they resell what they bought for an absurd amount of money. Today, we're going to be talking about this massive issue that's been plaguing 2020 with every major product launch that gamers are excited about, and specifically how this exact same thing is happening with the new PlayStation 5, which was recently released in November. And believe it or not, Sony is actually taking a huge revenue hit because of consumers scalping the PlayStation 5. It's gotten to the point where currently in Europe, there are legal legislations being put in place in order to outlaw the extreme extent of reselling products, which is something drastic that you normally wouldn't see very often, and likely something that would never happen in America. But the EU is taking action against scalping, which has brought this issue to the forefront of the gaming world. Now, PlayStation reported that there are no problems with the production for the PS5. Somehow I don't really believe that, but it is what it is. I digress. Even though the PlayStation 5 is already expected to outsell the PlayStation 4 based on its launch year, the ratio of console purchases to game purchases simply are not adding up for the PS5 release. Now, to put it in perspective, a healthy ratio is typically one game purchase for one console bought. But for the next gen console, the PlayStation 5 released, Sony sold around 213,000 consoles in the first month, and in that same amount of time, only 63,000 physical games were purchased. Now, you could argue that the PlayStation didn't have many first party titles at launch that were worth purchasing, that is. Backwards compatibility is new, and game subscriptions are also a relevant thing, taking this generation by storm, but the number is still abnormally small. As you can see, those numbers are way off compared to a typical ratio for the release of a new console. You can already see the effect this has on Sony, because all of their consoles are just sitting in corners and waiting to be sold instead of being used and played on. When hardware sales are on the low side, software sales are particularly important at the beginning of the console's life cycle. With the quick transition into digital downloads and games with consoles released this time around, software sales are a lot more important than they used to be for other console generations. And even with the software sales included in the ratio we spoke about before, the numbers still did not add up, even though the PlayStation 5 literally released with its own free game on the console. According to an analyst that spoke to Bloomberg, the consumer's inability to acquire the console, along with that causing a decline in the software sales, could negatively impact the profitability of the PlayStation business over the coming years. This is a big deal. The fact that a company as large as Sony is being affected this badly due to scalpers is not something you see every day. And the thing that's even more sad is that there are people out there that see scalping as something that doesn't affect anything, and it's something that can just be simply shrugged off as a minor inconvenience, and all other companies can just skip on their merry way without acknowledging it. But this situation with Sony is a prime example as to how those people are wrong. A multi-billion dollar company is expecting a decline in profit for a product that is expected to outperform their last product by a lot, yet people say that nothing is affected by scalpers, and it's a norm in every industry, and we should just get over it. But I say no. Thankfully, there are a lot of wise people that choose to not buy from scalpers like myself and you guys, which leaves them also at a loss of money. If the scalpers buy a few PlayStation 5s for the regular price and they don't get them sold, then when the demand is back to normal from Sony, they're going to be stuck with a few PS5s that have no use for and would probably have to sell them for less than the original price, or at bare minimum, the original price of the console. This is a prime reason why it's not smart to buy from scalpers. Their primary objective is to put you out of as much money as you're willing to spend, and it's a better idea to simply be patient and just wait for demand to increase again, and enjoy the idea of scalpers losing out of as much money as possible. But this honestly just is not something that should be normal for consumers. It's very inconvenient to have to wait on a product due to the actions of greedy people, or rather greedy people that have bots that are coded to ruin people's days, like me. And I don't know about you guys, but I've been trying to get a 3000 series graphics card for weeks now, and I haven't been able to due to scalpers and their Grinch bots. The gaming industry is the future of entertainment, so stuff like this that causes developers to delay their games, which is already a rampant issue for the PS5, not counting Cyberpunk because that should have been delayed for other reasons that we're not going to talk about in this video, but this causes backsliding to what is supposed to be a thriving industry. As I said before, scalpers will hopefully lose profit if people like you and me choose to stop buying overpriced products from resellers. But unfortunately, a recent study on the resale market for the PlayStation 5 and Xbox Series X shows that scalpers are reportedly making over $28 million on eBay alone as of December 1st, which is less than a month after the release of the new consoles. Assuming that the PS5 makes up half of those, the PlayStation 5 scalpers together made $14 million on eBay alone, including other bidding sites such as Craigslist, Facebook Marketplace, and more. These numbers are higher and will likely keep increasing until the demand of the product is back to normal. It's super interesting to think about how laws are starting to be made to prevent this issue from affecting large companies such as Sony, and I look forward to seeing what the punishments will be for breaking these laws. Now, you could argue that this is partially Sony's fault for not stopping the bots or having a system in place that prevents situations like this, but I digress. Overall, I feel like scalping is something that most people don't see as a big deal, but the reality is it is, and it's affecting billion-dollar companies in extreme ways. Unless laws start being created in more countries other than just Europe, this problem will likely be ongoing for the foreseeable future. But only time will tell how this will affect the future of console releases and gaming in general. Well, that wraps it up with this video. All my homies hate scalpers. Thanks for watching, and I will see you on the next one.